In the 1920s, the city of Hanover, Germany was terrorized by the Hanover vampire. His name was Fritz Harmann, and his early adolescence had been tainted with accusations of molesting children. After a brief stint in the army, Harmann opened a butcher shop and settled into society as a good citizen. He became a police buff and informant, helping Hanover detectives with tips about the city's petty criminals. The nearby Hanover train station was crowded with homeless boys and young men in transit from job to job. Harmann used his association with the police to roam the train station late at night and pick up young boys. He lured them along with the promise of a warm bed and food. Once in his home, Harmann would use his large body to pin the boy down and suddenly sink his teeth into the boy's throat in a fatal bite. Harmann would usually dismember the body and store the parts throughout his house. But perhaps the most horrifying detail of this case is what Harmann did with the body parts. To the shock of his customers, Harmann had ground up the body parts and made them into sausages, which he ate himself and also sold to his customers. By official count, Harmann's deadly bite claimed 24 victims, although some thought it might be higher. There have been other vampire-like murderers, such as Englishman John Hay. Hay was executed for the murder of 9 people in the 1940s. Hay claimed to be motivated by the sole desire to drink his victims' blood. He would lure them into a storeroom where he worked, then bash them over the head or shoot them. He would plug up the wounds to halt the loss of blood and then delicately slice open an artery in the neck. He would catch the blood in a cup and drink it until he felt refreshed. Many of these vampires have been labeled clinical vampires because of the sexual pleasure most derived from seeing or drinking blood. Of course, their blood fetishes have been taken to the extreme of mass murder. But there are some vampires who will go to this extreme. In our own country, mass murderers Ted Bundy, David Berkowitz, Richard Trenton Chase, and Jeffrey Dahmer all had vampire connections. Bundy bit his victims and said he felt like a vampire. Son of Sam Berkowitz claimed he had been poisoned by blood-sucking demons that compelled him to kill. Chase, dubbed the vampire killer by the press, drank the blood of at least one of his 6 victims, thinking it would cleanse him. And Dahmer ate the flesh and drank the blood of some of his victims. And there were other lesser-known cases. In 1981, James Riva was sentenced to life imprisonment in Massachusetts for shooting his grandmother and drinking her blood from the bullet holes, insisting all the while he was a vampire. In 1982, Jerry Moore killed his girlfriend in Chicago and drank her blood to gain strength. And in 1989, 3 boys killed a vagrant in Minnesota, licking the blood off their hands as they beat him. One of the boys cited the vampire film The Lost Boys as his inspiration. Of course, none of these murderers are nowadays spoken of as vampires, not in any serious sense anyway. People describe them as disturbed, mentally ill, or sociopathic. People tend to regard them as a modern phenomenon, byproducts of our unnatural, stress-skewed society. But are they vampires? Perhaps.